want to thank you for joining us on a beautiful, is it spring or is it winter? It's one of those things. Afternoon with the Austin Peay State University Symphony Orchestra. My name is Gregory Walmick, and I'm the conductor of this talented group of students and community members. This is our third and final performance of the year. We'll be returning at the very end of the semester to serve as the pit orchestra for collaboration with Opera Theater. Today's a special concert for a number of reasons. First of all, anytime we get to tackle Verdi, that's a great day. Second of all, we get to feature some incredibly talented winners of our annual concerto and aria competition. So we have about 20 students audition for us at the very end of the fall semester, and delighted to have two graduate students who are going to be appearing in that role. First, we're going to introduce in just a moment talented singer Tyler Saunders, and then we're also going to be hearing a graduate conducting student, but also a saxophonist and clarinetist extraordinaire, Chris Dial, who'll be playing the Villa Lobos soprano saxophone piece with string orchestra. And as an added feature with that, Chris is a graduate conducting student, and Sarah Turner, our other graduate conducting student, will actually be leading the orchestra in collaboration with Chris for that. We're now going to turn our attention to music of Gustav Mahler and his first two songs of The Wayfarer. Could you please welcome to the stage Tyler Saunders.
Thank you.
rest of the second half, and a massive work by Finnish composer Jean Sibelius. We, for the last several years, have used this first concert of the spring semester as an opportunity for the orchestra to tackle a project larger in scope, more difficult than anything we've done before. And it has been such a thrill to put this work together with these talented students and community members. For those of you not familiar with Sibelius' music, I think it is incredibly approachable on first hearing, but so many levels can be found upon further study. Sibelius was a Finnish composer, and the climate there is very different from, say, in the American South. And I think that you will hear some of the chill of the Arctic Circle, if you will, over the course of this sweeping symphony in E minor. He was, I think there's influences of the melodic gifts that we heard from Verdi in the first half, as well as Tchaikovsky and Russia, who just preceded him. But there's also an amazing use of silence that happens in a couple of dramatic moments in the piece that is really unlike anyone that had come before him. Well, I guess the best thing to do is let the music speak for itself. I hope you enjoy John Sibelius' first symphony.